Hi, lovely people. I hope you're good and you're having a beautiful day. It's so nice to be back again, and I am excited to bring you the continuation of our topic, move to Switzerland and EU from mostly African countries. So today I will be giving you the topic on the interview, because the day you submit your documents after the legalization process, you know, you'll be called, and after the lawyer has interviewed you and everything went well, you'll be called for the interview process. So this is what happens after you do that, and the day you go to submit the documents, you will be interviewed by two or maybe one, I don't know, in some embassies, but like where I had my own interview, you'll be interviewed by two of the officials in the embassy. So today I'm going to be giving you the likely interview questions. This is something that I really went through while I was trying to like do my process. I tried searching, or what are the likely questions you would be asked at the embassy, but I couldn't find any video like that on YouTube, and it really broke my heart then. So I had to just let go and let God. So today I'm bringing you the topics. I'll be reading them from my phone because it's been a couple of years and I can't remember all the questions like off heart. So the likely questions you'll probably be asked at the embassy is your questions about your everything on your application form. That's why it's always best to use only informations which you understand and true informations. Don't just write something and say, oh, let me just fill something there. If you know you are not sure of it, or if you know it's not correct, please, I've been emphasizing on this, please do not write it in your form, because even after the embassy lawyer has come and interviewed you, you will still be interviewed by these people in the embassy, and they will ask you the same question because they are holding your form, and you might just be like, I can't remember this, and then you look stupid, and then they deny your application. So they ask you about the things on the form. They ask you, the second thing, set of things they'll ask you is about, when I say the things on the form, that's your the names you filled, your school and everything. They would ask you about that, your everything on the application form you filled, just memorize it. Then they also ask you about your spouse or whoever is your sponsor there. When they ask you about your spouse, what they want to know is his name, his features, one of the officials asked me, what is a specific distinct feature if I see your husband and I can say, oh, this is your husband, and without you even telling me. So I had to describe the height, the looks, the hair color. You just have to describe if there's like a special mark on their body or like in the visible part of their body. You would also tell them at the embassy to show, oh yes, I really know this person. So another thing they would ask you also is, tell me about the house. Where is it located? What is the address of the place? What kind of, is it a house? Is it an apartment? You would talk about it. Okay, where is it located? Like, what are the landmarks to that place? You would talk about it. Then for your spouse or your sponsor, they would also ask you about his job, his salary. Those are questions, things you need to know, especially if it's a spouse visa. They'll ask you all those questions. Then they would also ask you for your plans for the future. If you don't have kids, do you intend on having kids? How many? How do you plan on raising them? Like, when I say raising them, like, are you going to have someone to help you watch them? Are you going to work? Those are questions they would also ask you at the embassy. So you should be prepared and have that in mind. In some cases, I didn't have that experience, but in some cases, they might even ask you about your sexual preference with your partner. So nothing is off limits at that interview. So just be prepared. Don't feel offended. Ask to answer to the best of your ability. Then They would also ask you about your family members, which you mentioned in the form, your parents, what they do, their age, your siblings, relatives, friends, or anybody's name you had on that form. They'll ask you about them, your how, apart from your relationship with them, okay, what are the things about them, like what they do. And they might ask you, their apart from their age, their features, or different things. So just expect anything from them. Then if it's a family reunion visa, they will ask you, how did you meet your spouse? Where did you meet and how did you meet? How long did you date each other? When did you decide to marry this person? Or when did he propose, or rather, why did you accept the proposal? How long have you been married? How was your wedding? How many wedding guests did you have? Where did you get married? So they will ask you all those questions. Did you have a traditional wedding also? Because the embassy only recognizes the African traditional wedding and the one you do in the Ministry of Marriage Interiors. That's the marriage registry. Those are the two. So even if you do church wedding, it's just a bonus or just for picture's sake. But those are the two they always require from at the embassy. The certificate and a picture of the traditional marriage to show that both families know each other. It's not just a sham marriage. So they'll ask you that. Then they'll ask you about yourself. What do you plan on doing when you arrive there? What are the things you like doing? What were you doing in Nigeria before you relocate? Before you plan on relocating now? Do you have a job? They'll ask you all those things about yourself. And when you get there now, like, what are the things you would like to, like, engage yourself in? How do you feel about, how do your parents feel about you traveling and relocating? So they will ask you all that to be sure, oh, okay, everybody's on board with this in your family. Even though they've interviewed your parents, and they'll ask, oh, how do you feel about, like, my own kids? We're like, oh, so now if you leave your mom and your mom is sick and you have to, just questions that your mom is sick and you have to come back, are you going to come back? Are you going to leave your kids and your husband over there? Just like psychology questions, just to like throw you off guard. And you have to like, oh, okay, you think before you answer and be real. Don't use borrowed questions, borrowed answers. Just answer and don't answer what they did not ask you. Because some people get carried away and start like talking. No, don't blab. Then they would also ask you about the country you are relocating to. You talk about the name of the country. Excuse me. You talk about the name of the country. You talk about the population, the government in the country, the what else again would you need to know? Where it's located in, if it's in Europe here, yeah, because we're talking about Europe. Where in Europe? Is it Central Europe, Northern Europe? All that you need to know. You need to know also the capital of that country. So all these things are things you should know if you are relocating to somewhere. So they need to know, oh yes, this person is not just traveling, relocating here, she has interest or he has interest in our country. So after that, I don't know, they could ask you maybe some additional questions, but these are the major questions you should expect at the embassy when you go there. And please try not to mess it up. Try not to make mistakes. Even if you do, don't feel bad. Sometimes you can get tense. It can be because they're like throwing questions at you from different corners. So just relax and smile. No matter how crazy it gets, hand everything to God and just be yourself. Be yourself. And don't answer what you were not asked. Please try not to. So this is the third stage of the visa, residence permit application process. So I'll be bringing you again the final stage very soon. So thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell. Please don't forget to reshare this video, because there are lots of people who have problems with this embassy questions and they really don't even know what to do or what to say and all that. Then I would also advise you, in case your process is taking so long, try to tell your sponsor or your spouse in the European country you are relocating to to get an immigration lawyer in that country, not in your home country, in the country you are going to. Then that person can help you like check the status of your application over there, because they wouldn't answer your spouse and they wouldn't answer